Bro.
First, you know, my name is, rap name is Crumb Snatcher, professionally known as Crumb Snatcher. You know, what we doing, we just introduce you to my barber slash bodyguard. His name is Rob. You know, he's real instrumental in, you know, keeping me safe out here and, you know, trying to hold me down and give me good advice. Basically, we're just going to introduce you to this cat, man, you know what I'm saying? Show you know who touches me up all the time. You know, he's a good dude.
So this is what it comes to, huh? I gotta officialize myself. Okay, come on.
Big dog.
Hey, yeah.
Good.
What's up, baby?
What's going on?
Just chilling.
Where you been?
Working,
yeah.
Still, you know.
Yeah,
you know,
thinking about you, dog.
Yeah, man.
Thinking about you.
Yeah, I mean, I gotta come get touched up, man. Need the edge up.
Yeah.
Please, if you don't mind, sir.
Me and Crumb's been our friends since 97. I met him in prison. I was doing time in prison, state prison. One day I just heard him rapping out in the yard, and I introduced myself to him because I was like one of the OGs in prison. Everybody looked up to me. And then when I got out, and he asked me did I wanted to be his bodyguard.
Yeah, you know, I met Rob upstate, man. You know, he's just one of the star basketball players. You know, everybody loved Rob up there, man. You know, he ain't a little dude either, so, you know, very intimidating looking, you know. But he was up there playing ball, and I was up there doing all the rapping and stuff, you know.
He basically looked at me, you know, as a mentor, you know. So we had a lot in common as far as losing. I lost my goal, you know what I mean, in the NBA. That was my goal. And him being a rapper, you know, jail took away his goal, but he got it back.
You know, I like Rob, man, because, you know, he's a positive brother. Though we met, you know what I'm saying, where we was at.
Now, you know, it's like, you know, working with Crumb, you know, I'm able to be that, you know, that positive person, you know what I mean, that he always needed because he never had it. And the friends that he said he had, that I told him he didn't have, he sees that now, you know what I mean? Because now that he's down on his back, trying to climb back up, you know, where's his friends at? You know, and now with his new mixtape coming out, a new album getting ready to drop, you know, finally, you know what I mean? He sees, you know what I mean, the light of day again.
All right, here we go, y'all.
Basically, I'm born and raised in Brooklyn, New York.
Yeah, Kenny's my dog from Brooklyn, man. I met Kenny, he used to throw shows out here.
Since I've been in the picture, man, everything's been real. You know, everything he spits is real, definitely. And, you know, I just appreciate it, too, because I'm a lover of music. I'm a fan first, man.
Well, you know, I used to be signed in Interscope, to Interscope in 98. You know, a couple bad issues happened. It sort of, like, stigmatized me in the industry.
I'm here because this is where I feel I'm comfortable, man. You know, where I feel I'm real at, man. I don't feel like I'm going to get crossed or stabbed in the back in this situation, you know. And that's what usually happens, man, in this game, man. So many people, they show shady, man. There's no loyalty, man.
I think loyalty is definitely first and foremost out of anything, man. You know what I'm saying?
I didn't want to press you anyway.
I've went through a lot of different rappers I've helped, and, you know, after they got their name or they got what they wanted from me, you know, they basically shitted on me. You know what I'm saying? So I'm really, really skeptical now.
You know, when you say loyalty, you know, he's very loyal to himself, to his music, you know, because he could have, like I told you, he could have gave up. Stuff he's going through, he could have gave up, but he didn't.
You know, when I was just rapping in the prisons, Rob, you can verify that. You know, everybody loved me.
Oh,
you
yeah,
know? Now when you get a certain position, a certain name, you know what I'm saying? Now everybody wants to knock you down or try to do certain things to make you fall, you know? All right, check this out, y'all. We at our Straight Up Entertainment Studios right here. You know what I'm saying? It don't look like much on the outside, but we're going to take you inside. You're going to see how, you know, the place where I record the majority of my album.
My daydream girl,
Basically, this is my engineer and my dog, Todd. You know what I'm saying? He's a good dude. Everything, like the last album, he did the majority of the work. My big dream girl.
I think he's such a versatile MC who can come at you fucking blazing, tearing your head off on a track, and can turn around and on the very next track on the CD or at a show, all of a sudden mellow out, get the lighters going, get the candles going, and get the chicks up in front of the stage going, my God, I want to fuck him. He's that kind of MC where he can do that.
My big dream girl. My big dream girl. What do you think, Todd?
Well, basically, you know, I've been in the studio with a lot of people around me that was yes men, you know. So, you know, I used to get crazy drunk in the studio. We used to have guns all in the studio. It was just like mad negative energy, you know. You know, dudes, I just go in the booth and say anything, and everybody's like, yeah.
Yeah, they're going to say yes because they're here, you know, kind of for Crumb. And I think it's more important for someone to be a little bit objective about it and be like, you might want to listen to this again.
You know, now, you know, you're hearing the change in the music because now, you know, I'm changing my surroundings and feeling more comfortable with who I am and the direction I'm trying to go. So that's why the music is changing, because my atmosphere and my surroundings is changing. All right, we're moving on to the next joint. We're doing a sound check real quick. You know, it's a little more of an up-tempo joint, more talking about my life, you know what I'm saying? So it's called Journal. All right, check it out.
I went through different stages, doing drugs to toting gauges. From people in my own crew turning into haters. They prayed and prayed for my downfall. I had to tell myself I gotta get away from around y'all. All this negative energy had me all surrounded. Perceiving me as selfish, I guess that's how I sounded. Well, it's time for me to focus on me. And I ain't getting younger, so I hope this I'ma be. I won't be disappointed if this one guy tried.
Some true stuff right here, watch this.
Had dealers in my circle when he drug most had it. Till I came face to face battle in a coke habit. Some won't admit it, too wrapped up inside the gimmick. It's one life to live it, best believe me trying to live it. Thinking back in Florida, my man Simon died. Doing Xanax and Percocets, man, I heard I cry.
Wanna hear it?
Yeah.
Yo, it's my VA Wolves right here. You know me, we got different chapters, different areas, but they helped me run the whole Wolves chapter. It's Big Ty right there.
Murray's
it's my brother. It's Itchy Fang right there.
Soldier since day one. Check it out. Warriors, organizing life, values, escaping struggles. It's Wolves, that's us, man. I mean, this is our logo. You look at it as an animal, but we look at it as a personal, physical thing within the spirit of the wolf.
You know, we doing, you know, trying to do big things, man. You know, Wolves is a good movement, man.
All right, Todd, I'm ready when you ready.
Yeah, all right.
Come on, man, we got the chemistry, dog. We got it, we go.
Everywhere you go, I'm there. Everything you see, I'm right there. Anything you need, I'll be there. Anything you want, I'm there.
Man, him been together since, you know what I'm saying? We was living together, eating chicken 365 days out the year. You know what I'm saying? Doing that grind, putting in mad work.
Anything you want, I'm there.
Cat got game, man. The cat got heart and he got mind. And he's trying to bring back what hip-hop been missing. You gotta remember, he's the first cat, independent, that hit the source, man. You got me on quotable, son.
Basically, like I was saying, man, you know, I got like 5 notepads just like this. Most of them is filled up, you know. So what I'm doing right now is just staying on top of this thing right here, man, you know. See this? But all these rappers is on mixtapes and doing that. I got over 60 songs already to pick out of a new album. And I'm still recording, as you see today.
I got the world on my back from subliminal flows. So let me take you to the world where criminals go. Individuals know I'm everywhere like they ghost. And the underrated artists who get mentioned the most. I'm like a plague.
Hey, you thinking my voice is too high pitched?
That was beautiful, Doc. You continue your story now, which is good. That's how you do a song. You amp it, then you continue the story. So let your ad libs boost it up now.
Okay.
You need some high ad libs.
Provide it, can't deny it. Snakes in the grass, but these wolves stay united.
Oh man, this is the best workout, man. You don't have to go to the gym. You go in here and sweat up. Put that energy in the music, you know?
Nothing but intelligent gangsters and far from them haters. That's under my nature. When y'all gonna learn on becoming a man, dog? It don't mean you come because the guns in your head, dog.
Everywhere you go.
Ha! Yeah, that's what's up.
First off, we're here at Playground Records, where it used to be Playground Records. This is where, you know, we started as far as in the hip-hop scene in this area. It was like a monument as far as the music. So we're gonna go over here real quick. This is where I met my dog Ty at too, Geo. It's the first time we met. We was in here freestyling, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
putting our name on the map.
This is my C right here, it's God's son, you know what I mean? This is Lil Ty right here, you know what I'm saying? This is our future, but we're gonna walk down here. This right here is where it all took place at. The God came in from Worcester, you know what I'm saying, walking through, and we was in there freestyling that day. Came in, blew it up, and there's history. I used to live across the street right there, 195 Essex. This is our hood right here.
No, basically, man, I had just came out of jail, you know what I'm saying? And these brothers was in here freestyling every day, so I seen them. I was a couple, you know, kind of shy to, you know, go in and freestyle, you know, first couple of times, so I would just peek through the window, you know what I'm saying? Then one time I seen them in there, and they called me in there, you know what I'm saying? They gave me the mic.
Basically, it was Walking the Dog production then, you know what I'm saying? That was Lenny Thomas. So, I mean, he put it down, you know what I'm saying? Gave him the wavelength on it, you know what I'm saying? Scientifics come through here and everything. That's where him and Crumb start building that. You know what I'm saying? It's all history from right there.
I'm saying, you know, a lot of memories in this spot right here, man. This is where, you know, a lot of shootouts would happen here, man. It was just crazy out here.
Big shootout right here. This window right here was shot out right here. This one was gone where he's standing over there. That one was shot out. My man was shot right here in the back right here. You know what I'm saying? I had my son, he was in the inside. So basically we had to defend ourselves from all angles, you know what I'm saying?
You know, we had a lot of problems with different people in the area. They thought, you know, we was probably basically trying to take over because the attention we was getting as far as the music. So, you know, we had to defend ourselves out here. Right down the street is the spot where I got shot at. All right, basically where we at, we on spot with the location where I got shot at. You know, just follow me, basically I'll show you what happened. We had a fight with some kids. Well, actually, one of my boys had got cut from these other cats in here. And, you know, one of the guys inside reached for a pistol, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, they didn't know that we was armed ourselves. So, you know, as he was reaching, I had pulled out and fired onto them as they ran outside. Just follow me real quick. What they did, you know, these guys were smart dudes. They took cover behind another car that was across the street, you know? And what happened was, as it came out the pool hall shooting, they ducked behind a car and I turned around. So as I turned around to originally go get the person that we was after, I was shot in the back of the arm. So, you know, that sort of dropped me on one knee. As I turned around to get up to fire back in exchange, I was shot in the chest. You know, I got back up and again, I was shot again here. That's where I fell at right here. And my boys picked me up. We was going down the street. I was shot again in the back. It was crazy, man. You know, the hospital, Lawrence General was down the street. So we made it into the hospital. They carried me to the hospital. As I came into the hospital, I collapsed. And like all the blood rushed into my throat. So they had to fly me from Lawrence General in a helicopter. The helicopter came and got me and they took me to Boston General. But you know, gives you goosebumps, man, just to see, you know, we're almost, you know, my life could have ended right here. It's crazy.
On the aspect of him getting shot, you know what I'm saying? I mean, that hurt everybody, not only him, but families. You know what I'm saying? That shit hit everybody. So the way he act now, you know what I'm saying? He's not acting out shit. This is the way he is. When you're that close to death, you see a different light.
I'm surprised we here at this age right now, surviving. We got the young guy with us, man, you know what I'm saying? And we're not talking to glorify. We just more on the aspect of what we came through and where we trying to head towards.
Listen, I don't care what nobody says to me. I'll pluck you, be crying like Batman or Vanity. I rap so I'm here to even the score. You snap at me, I'ma clap back at you like Ja did 50. I have you running like Ren and Stimpy. Get it? Ren and Stimpy.
Going down.
He's doing all his writing himself right now.
Yeah, that's what's
rooming him into be a young MC. This is the young Crumb right here. This is what the future gonna look forward to, you know what I mean? Y'all cats watch out. That's Lil Ty. Word up.
Basically, man, we are gonna go to see my man Scientific's gravesite. I was the rapper out here. He was the biggest rapper at the time. Basically, this is the guy who discovered me and recognized my talent before anybody else. There's a lot of things that go on out here. It may seem like a small town, but you know those towns are the worst because you know these kids out here got, you know, a lot to prove, you know. So you know, small towns to me is like the worst, and you wonder why a lot of, you know, songs, you know, about violence,
certain things kids can only rap about what they, where they come from and what they see.
For every bullet shell that fly, a raindrop drip from the sky. Tears from the universal why. Gunshots and needles, the problem of my people. How they can meet you behind the next desert eagle. We celebrate life like it's close to our death. Teaching all the seeds with every strength in my breath. Pull my thoughts out and let it spill on the paper. Wrenching my heart for every word.
Basically, this is the brother I was talking about, Scientific. Rest in peace. That was the brother who put me on.
Cause right now I'm lonely. Pour liquor for my homies, somebody show me. Big L Stretch and Tom, all gifted. Trouble Big Buff plus my man Scientific. Long live the martyrs of this game. Embracing your name, may you be sheltered from the flames. God bless.
You know what's up? Appreciate it, you know?
We taking rap too serious. Now it's worth a life. You say the wrong name, you pay a large price. What happened to that hip hop? Play the park after dark. Now we can't meet without shots about the spark. I laid down to sleep.
Good dude, you know, he's the one that put me on, so I always pay my respects. And I would never do anything negative to that man. I wouldn't be where I'm at if it wasn't for that man. You know, I just wish he was still here, you know, that way he could see, he seen the talent before anybody did, you know.
Did so much dirt with men, most pedals fall as another gun blaze. I'm just a victim of this world's ugly ways.
I was told by the doctor that to watch him because he's so sharp and so intelligent that if he can find the easy way out, that's the route he would take. This is what this doctor explained. I thought he's only a year old. What's man talking about?
My mom is a good woman. Definitely a good woman. You know, I was raised in a household that everybody was good people. They was focused. They, you know, they wanted to raise me right, you know.
Did you wash your hands?
Now they throw you under the
bus?
Nope.
You wash your hands?
Nope.
Oh, this is my Uncle Randy for everybody out there. Definitely played an instrumental part of my life.
Yeah, thanks a lot.
You know, so I had a little, you know, time I was getting a little too wild and everything. My mom couldn't handle me, so she sent me to the general, you know? And, you know, he was on me.
I had him come stay with me for a while, get him in school, get him in football, you know, kind of help him focus a little bit on what he wanted to do.
Very appreciative of still my family still being there, even when I did have my time and was sort of turned my back on my family. It was too much into the streets and, you know, my friends and everything, but they stood by me through it all, you know, even the lockups.
He had to find out by going out with these people, being dedicated to them, getting shot 7 times, them walking away, who was there? The real family.
He's had a hard time coming up, this, that, and the other, but he's always loved music.
His music is his world. He has it in his, it's in his blood. It's in his blood.
Okay.
Thank you, bro. My mom, you know, she's been there every step of the way. So she know, you know, she just says, you know, I may not agree with what you're saying, but I know you're just expressing yourself.
What about the hot sauce? You put them on to the famous hot sauce?
It's the real deal.
Mix hot sauce.
Dr. Jekyll. I should like you up. Just put a little pain on you. Need a little flavor. How's it taste, brother?
This is hot. Delicious. When I tell you my head is going to sweat,
if you keep the camera right there, you're going to see balls of perspiration.
Got to be able to deal with, homie.
Yeah.
I've been sweating for years.
Yeah.
I'm immune.
This
in the laboratory, sweating it out.
Coming
out the formula.
Uh-huh. I mean, this is the life of a real artist, a real rapper. You know, there's no images to portray. You know, I'm all about positivity and my family. That's what it's about. You know what I'm saying? That's first and foremost.
Back up Colonel Sanders. Yeah. I mean, life is, you always got uphill, downhill, okay? And he ran into a few snags along the way. But like I said, he's the man he is today because he just brushed it off his shoulders and life goes on. It didn't make him, it won't destroy him.
What's up, y'all? We're in New York City right now. We're in Headquarters Studios, owned by Primo. We're doing a song called Do What I Gotta. And you know, just fall back.
Don't you know, K, keep the game in its smash. That's why I keep popping up like a criminal's past. And my brain truly contained top best flow, outside looking in. Time to pass the threshold, who don't
yes,
feel
her. King
ruler, universe,
it's going down.
And my throne, you gon' nail her. Kiss the ring on the dawn, he got the charm. You can hear it in his voice when he gracing a song. One more time soon, please.
This is soon. Yeah. Family.
Definitely, you know? Man. My man Crumb laid it down again. All right, let's check it out.
Okay.
All right. Well, the studio is a big extension of my whole career from 1992 on up. I've never gone to any other studios but here, which was D&D Studios, so it was like a big deal for any artist to even say that they worked at D&D. People used to say it on the record, just leave a quick shout out just so that people knew when the record came out, oh, he did it at D&D.
Primo, D&D, y'all. That's right.
And then they shut down. You know, I knew I had to do something to either get it back or to just have to readjust my whole situation, which is what I had to do for a minute, and then I finally got it. All
right, I got it.
Okay, are you ready to go?
Yes.
All right.
Oh, it's definitely an old home, you know. I've been coming up here for years, you know, at least like the last 2 years. You know, and I've seen a change in it. You know, Primo's doing big things in here, you know, so I can't wait, you know, to come up here, man, and do some good music, you know.
K-Dot.
Get the real hip-hop sound, because this is where it's at, you know.
You know, even though he missed a lot of the years in the earlier years, he still got to experience a lot of history from being here and being part of some great albums, you know, so. It's definitely a pleasure to have him in our lives and on wax, you know, so still putting it down.
Honestly, I'm a little nervous because, you know, it was some big legends in the building.
Last line, please.
This is where I recorded, you know, my last two albums, man, so, you know, it's a good atmosphere, good people. I'm just a little nervous because I haven't been here in the studio for a long time, so.
My fault, son. I messed up in the beginning, my fault.
All right, ready when you are.
Okay.
Yo, Duke, pop the battle, Christian Cap, go back one more time. I'm sorry.
All right, I got it. I got it for sure. Right.
When you came in the other ones, you're a little bit more like aggressive.
Okay.
Let me get that aggressive flow back.
Okay.
Yeah. Aggressive Bakai.
Hey, yo, Duke, pop the bottle, twist the cap on back. Hat low, fresh Dickies laying black on black. I remain to move on any terrain and let it rain. Got the whole world sympathy, they feeling my pain. Like a sympathy of
one more time.
Man, I park, I'm just trying to do me, dog, spit from the heart. If rap is art, I'm trying to be his Picasso. A verse is more harder than El Paso Tabasco. All
right, you just got to match that energy from the first verse.
Okay.
Keep the same flow. I mean, same energy throughout the whole.
That's the energy. You just gotta get in the pocket a little bit more, and you ran out of breath.
You know, I'm just gonna write a new verse.
So then, feel free.
All right.
I met him through his former partners. His partners were up here a lot doing some remixes because Crumb was in jail at the time.
He was supposed to do a remix and he wasn't feeling a remix. He was like, well, I got a beat right here. So, you know, he played the beat, you know what I'm saying? He's like, you got something for that right now? And I had already had it in my head, so I just jumped in the booth because I just got done, you know, getting shot and going to jail and coming out. So, you know, I had a little something to get off my chest anyways.
When he went in the booth, he just was so energetic with the flow and the delivery. I was like, damn, this dude, all right. From there, you know, I let Guru here, and Guru was like, yo, man, we need to get him down with Gangstar Foundation. He's from Massachusetts. And just the whole Gangstar, you know, originated from Massachusetts. So when we started doing our album in 98, you know, the Gangstar album, we was like, yo, we got to get Crumb on another joint. And he did a joint called Make 'Em Pay. Just the whole energy of how Crumb put his lyrics down and his attitude, I could tell he was the next person to be destined to star and play in the role of MC, you know, in this rap game.
He was the first MC to ever get a hip-hop quotable in the Source magazine without a record deal. All right, my man Crumb Snatcher, straight out of Boston, Massachusetts, from Long Town.
Primo got me signed to Interscope, but my mind wasn't right, it wasn't focused. I was celebrating before. You know how you celebrate when you get a deal? I was celebrating already in the streets, you know what I'm saying? You know, I was in a stolen car, joyriding with pistols and all that, getting drunk. That was my vices back then. Now I'm a lot more older, a little more wiser, a little bit more focused on what my goal is.
I'm the alpha of my camp, born leader like Osiris is. Spread the word through your sidekicks and wirelesses. Hip-hop's death truly been prevented, cause your boy profound and he sounds so authentic. Game saturated with criminology raps. I step right in where originality lacks. On top of that, no, to spit something fierce, cause everybody say I'm the truth like Paul Pierce.
Alright, you want me to loop it?
I think we can leave it there. We can listen to it, see how it comes out. Then we decide if you want to, you know, add another verse or not.
Listen to it the way it is now?
Yeah, please.
All right, so come in here and check it out then.
Good? You good? Listen, good soon? We got it? We got it? Definitely. Got it? All right.
That's what's up. Sound good. I like that verse.
Thanks.
All right, so
does everybody say I'm the truth like Paul Pierce?
I'm just going to play it from the jump.
That's the new verse.
You know, it's been 10 years. So, you know, 10 years and I'm still striving. And, you know, I think Primo notices that. You know, I think my family notices that. Hip-hop music, it needs a revival, resuscitation, you know? Somebody got to stand up and resuscitate, you know?
I failed, man, the scores been countless. Reminiscing how I used to sleep on floors and couches. Ballers with the hot girls and DG jeans. While my pockets flat broke, I can't eat these dreams. Starving like Marvin just to see me blow. To be the next entrepreneur and CEO. Wanna touch the sky, you gon' have to try and fly. Everybody want heaven, but nobody want die. Take the easy route, tempting to me. Until I realize my circle was reflections in me. If I ain't successful, my squad ain't successful. With disgruntled employees can be stressful.